Hello everybody, I'm trying something a little bit different today. So, as you all know, I dabble in Ruby from time to time, and I really like Ruby. When you like something, you tend to take notice of things, look at plot holes, look at all this, or just critically analyze it in any sort of way whatsoever. Now, I have decided to take it upon myself to basically ignore something that was stated in the show and provide my own personal opinion. Granted, that's probably nothing new for this fan base, but you must go on. Now, today we're going to be talking about five different ways to kill Salem. That is right, five. Now, we're just going to start because some of these range from stupid to smart to, oh, that kind of makes sense, or, oh, they might actually use that. So let's get the most obvious one out of the way, and that is Ruby Silver Eyes. Now, Ruby Silver Eyes are probably what's going to defeat Salem in the final arc. That's most likely what everyone has predicted. So it seems to be of great importance. They did kind of hint at that during Volume 7, during the journey to Robin's political victory party. God. Most likely Ruby's just going to freeze her, and that's going to put her in stasis and essentially keep her there for all of eternity until her mind goes completely blank, similar to what happened to Kars. And this will basically just kill her. It's not technically killing, but it basically is, bro. You're stuck in stone for eternity, so yeah. Next kind of stupid one, acid. So basically from her fight with Hazel, we see that she has a very good healing factor, but it's not good enough to where her body she has negative durability, to be honest. Like, bro, Yang broke through her defenses with like very few punches. Hazel completely shattered her with like one punch. And granted, yeah, sure, these characters are strong, but you have not seen Yang one-shot someone unless they're like actual fodder. So her durability is garbage. So what happens if you just like throw her in acid? Well, if you get strong enough acid, that will break her down and it will continually eat at her, hopefully faster than her regeneration can, you know, heal her. And that would force her to devote all of her magic into healing. And basically, and to be fair, acid does have like a date of expiration almost, where it becomes less and less acidic over time, but there is a chance that she might completely dissolve. And that also works for vaporization, similar to most other anime, for example, like Perfect Cell. If you vaporize every single atom in her body, she might not be able to come back from that. Granted, I don't know how they would do that. They would need some crazy firepower, and it's hard to see if anything would come across like that in Ruby. Now, third option to kill or stop Salem. Throw her in a vault. Specifically, a vault that you have access to that the others do not. Now, unfortunately, Atlas's vault got finessed. But one thing that has always shocked and something that we can all agree on is that magic has its own very obscure rules. So we can take what we do know and just sort of apply it. So if we throw Salem in the vault, will she be able to use magic to get out? No. No, she will not. Why? Well, that's simple. Cinder could not access any of the vaults on her own. She needed the Winter Maiden or the Spring Maiden in order to access said vault to get said relic. What does that mean? Well, that means that specific magic is required to unlock a specific door created by Ozpin. So that must mean that Salem, if she were to get locked in a dimension, like that, she would not be able to escape due to the fact that she does not have the magical requirements. Especially since she 100% has different magic from Salem. After all, magic does seem to be a little bit unique to each individual, but overlapping. Sort of like how semblances all sort of gain an extra feature, but aura is still the same. Something along those lines. Fourth one. It is time. Time for what? Well, it's time for a JoJo reference. Yeah, that's right, guys. Throw her into space. That's right, boys. It's about JoJo. It's part of JoJo. It's JoJo time. I love me some JoJo. Alright, so throwing her into space. It should work. Why? She doesn't appear to have aura at all. As stated before, her durability is actual garbage. So, the outer layer of her skin and body and clothes and all that would most likely freeze due to the intense cold of the outside world, or outside of the planet's atmosphere, to be correct. So, if you throw her into space, most likely she would not be able to come back from that due to her skin constantly being frozen, and she would not be able to repel herself and sort of be trapped in a cryogenic state similar to Silver Eyes, and basically have to wander through space through all of eternity, or get vaporized by the sun, which would most likely also kill her. Now, the other reference is from the best volume of Ruby so far, ha ha ha, and that is Volume 9. Now, Volume 9, we get introduced to the world of the Ever After, which is controlled and basically maintained by a divine tree. So how does that work? Well, the tree calls out to people who do not want to be themselves and can reforge you if you do not have strong enough will. This is an example. For example, Little changed completely. Yes, he is still nice. Yes, he is still genuine. But he is a different person with no memories of what happened. So, Salem would most likely fall victim to the tree if she were to be thrown in. How would they get there? Well, Ambrosius created a portal so he could do it again. Alright, everyone got that? Good. So, we have the way. Now, once she's in there, the tree will grab her, most likely, and consume her, much like it did to Ruby, Little, or Neo. Now, Salem, it's highly theorized that Salem wants to die, so most likely, I'm guessing, the tree would call out to her and she would most likely listen. So it's just a general question of whether or not she would be able to resist, which I do not think she would, especially since Little, once again, who Little actually had a most likely a larger desire to live, would want to continue. So this would lead to Salem being completely destroyed and reconstructed into a different form. Now, she may have a very similar personality, but it's important to remember that she does not know her past lives, so she will not be carrying that baggage. She also might not even be immortal at that point, because the tree will break her down and redistribute her, so it might straight up just take out immortality, especially since the tree is a rank above the gods, because the tree created the gods. So it should be able to undo her immortality and basically turn her either into a normal woman, turn her into something that will go back to Remnant and most likely not be as much of trouble, or she'll just become an Ever After. And so, yeah, that's what I mean. You have all these 5 different ways to kill Salem. I handed them out. Hopefully you guys were listening. I'm really glad that you all stuck around and listened for this little bit. And if you like to see more content, why not subscribe? Because, you know, I'm going to be producing stuff more frequently now. Anyway, I'm going to head out, and I'm going to see you guys eventually. Later.